Rose, and welcome to My Randomosity. If you're a subscriber of mine, yes, I am filming with my cell phone again because my camera is still broken. Well, this is going to be a video on my September favorites. Hopefully this will be really short because really, honestly, I don't have that much to talk about. I'm going to quickly scroll the different things I'm going to talk about, and also down in the description box, everything will be listed, so you can check that out. Get a sneak peek of what I'm about to talk about and see whether or not this video is something that would still interest you. Now, the first category I'm going to touch base on is nails, and I have three polishes. Two that are julep, and this first one is Debra. It's basically a bone smoky taupe cream. This is the first kind of nude polish that I've ever worn. And actually, I did like it. The fact that it was neutral, it coordinated with... Never do I actually ever match my nails to my outfit. I mean, look, they're highlighter neon green right now. But it coordinated really well with all the outfits that I wore. Now, this polish... And the next one I'm about to talk about, they were both incredibly thick. This one was so thick that I only had to dip my brush into the bottle once and was able to paint one coat on four of my nails, and one coat was fully opaque. And then this polish almost lasted on my nails for 2 weeks with no top coat whatsoever. So this was definitely a favorite. I got a ton of compliments on it when I wore it. Julep, they offer a great monthly beauty subscription service. I'll link down below my blog that I have, or the two blogs that I have about these two polishes, just so that you can learn more about it. And if you actually want to join the subscription service, in the description box, I have a referral link. If you go to my blog, there'll be a little banner that you can click on with a promo code where you can actually try your first month for free. So, Debra, a definite favorite. The next one is Simone, and my cell phone is probably not doing it justice, but it's basically a lilac that has a slight, don't know if it's pulling it up right there, but it has a slight lilac iridescence to it, but it's a cream finish also. This is almost, It basically reminded me of a Nicki Minaj color, and if you want to see, like, a more true depiction of it, then go to my blog that has the swatch picture that I'll link down below. You can also check out my Instagram, because I always upload my polish, my nail of the day pics to my Instagram, which my username is Rose Drummond. But this was nice, too. Incredibly thick, and it didn't last on my nails for almost 2 weeks like this, but it lasted probably almost a week and a half. Now, this last nail favorite I have is what I'm currently wearing. It's one of the brightest colors I've ever worn. And this is the first Pop Beauty polish I've ever owned. But this is their number 28, and it's called Radioactive, which I think is a very, very, very appropriate name for this. Because this, I mean, my cell phone is not doing it justice, and, you know, it's pretty dark. The contrast and the saturation of what my cell phone's recording. But this is so incredibly bright. Very pigmented. I think it only took like 2 coats. And I've had this polish on. Tomorrow will be a week. So. And I've been asked so many times in the past week, what do you have on your nails? So, Pop Beauty Nail Glam Nail Polish 28 Radioactive. Another September favorite. And that's it for nail polish favorites. I have one makeup item to talk about, and it's something that I've talked about in past favorites videos. I gotta admit that I've been kind of salvaging this because this is a very expensive, high-end, waterproof eyeliner pencil. So I've been using other eyeliners, but I was recently gifted this by my coworker slash friend. But this is the Clarins Waterproof Eyeliner in black, or noir, which is French for black. This is my holy grail eyeliner. I have found some close dupes to this, but This is the first eyeliner after I've tried so many drugstore and high-end eyeliners that actually works well on my incredibly oily skin. I guess the good thing about me recording with my cell phone right now is that you can really kind of see I powdered my face probably like 2.5 hours ago. But this is me not being the most shiny that I can get throughout the day. So eyeliner on me tends to run and gives me panda eyes. Now this, I can shower, I can work out, I can run, and this stuff will stay in place. So, definitely waterproof. You have to use a really good eye maker remover to remove this. I've sold so many of these at my work. I work in a cosmetic department within a department store. And it's so opaque that it has the look of liquid liner. So, if you're looking for a good waterproof pencil, I definitely recommend the Clarins Waterproof Eyeliner. And that is it for beauty favorites. If that's all you're interested in, you can stop watching now. I'm going to quickly go through the random favorites that I have. The first random favorite I have is another beauty subscription service, Birchbox. I've been a member with them for about a year and a half now. I have my referral link down below in case you're interested. They normally do have a wait list, but honestly, I've had a couple friends join recently, and they were off the wait list within like 2 to 3 days. But it's 10 bucks a month, so one of the cheapest monthly beauty subscription services that you can roll in. The reason why they're a favorite is because they actually sent me a duplicate item. An item that I had received in a previous month that I wasn't really that fond of. And I shot them a quick email. Their customer service is great. I basically emailed them just to notify them that, hey, you sent me, you know, something that I've already gotten before. And they responded within like a 24-hour period. And something that they have are Birchbox points that you can use to shop with their Birchbox shop. Basically, 100 points equals $10. They gave me 100 points for free, basically because I had just received a duplicate item of something that I didn't like, which I wasn't even expecting. So Birchbox, you definitely were a favorite of mine for the month of September for doing that for me, which I thought was great. The next three favorites are fellow YouTubers, or YouTubers, where I shouldn't really call them fellow because they're on a level. I'm not even on a level. They're actually on, like, the top level. And the reason why they're favorites is because these YouTubers have subscribers in the hundreds of thousands. And within the month of September, they actually, one actually responded to me via Instagram. And the other two actually replied to my comments on some of their videos, which I thought was amazing. The first one is Leanne Says. She's an incredibly adorable, quirky beauty guru. She does hauls and first impressions and empties videos. So cute, so funny. And she's the one who actually replied to a statement that I made on her Instagram. And then the next YouTuber is Charisma Star. She's this energetic, effervescent, lovely. I just can't help but think of Disney. She just reminds me of a Disney princess. She's incredibly talented, does great makeup tutorials on her channel. All these ladies, I'll have them, their channels linked below, so if you don't know who they are, you can check them out. But she actually responded to a comment that I made on one of her vlogs, which I thought was great. Had fangirl moments with all these three replies that I got. And the last one's Candy Johnson, who's very well known. She's this lovely, very bubbly, I can't help but smile whenever I watch one of her videos. Beauty guru, she's a great makeup artist. She does hauls and her favorite things and makeup tutorials. I'm gonna do a quick montage because I actually took screenshots of them replying to me. So I'll go ahead and play that for you really quick because I'm such a dork. Charisma Star and Candy Johnson. If you don't know who they are, definitely check them out, and I'll have their channels linked below. The next to the last random favorite I have is an app, and I'm gonna insert a screenshot of what the home screen of my cell phone looks like. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but the icons that I have for some specific apps look nothing like the default icons that you would normally have on your cell phone. Like, I have a strawberry sitting in whipped cream that represents Hulu Plus. Coco PPA is basically an app that you can download for free that basically gives you, like, custom design icons that are really cute. Icons and home screens that you can choose from that you can download for free. And that has to be my favorite app of the month. I completely downloaded new icons for every single app that I have on my home screens. So if you're sick of looking at the boring icons that you have on your home screen, then Coco PPA is an app that you should definitely check out. And the last September favorite I have, I don't know if it's necessarily a favorite because I'm really sad that it's over, would have to be the television show Dexter. Yes, the 8-year run is over. I'm very bummed. I don't know how my Sundays are going to be the same. I feel like a loser for saying this, but it's almost like I've lost a friend. This show has lasted longer than my last two serious relationships. And how it ended, I'm not going to give anything away. It's like, it was a good ending, but then at the same time, it was kind of like confusing and slightly a letdown. I might do a Dexter reaction video. If you think that would be a good idea, then definitely thumbs this video up or leave a comment. Because I just have so many things that I want to say that I don't want to say because I don't want to, like, spoil any of you guys that might be watching the show currently. But Dexter would definitely have to be my last random favorite for September. And this is it for my September faves. This might be one of the shortest favorites videos I've ever had. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave in a comment or message. And again, this is Rose from My Randomosity, and thank you so much for watching this crap. Hopefully the next video I upload, maybe with my actual camera, but I can't promise that. And until next time, I hope you all have a great day, and you will be seeing me hopefully very soon. We'll be right back.